Now, this is dated January 2nd, 2012. All right, that was roughly, I guess, around 12:50 a.m. Now, this is a couple days later, but this computer still has saved. Here you go. Save this clip. You see this clip right here where it says that NASA says that the apocalypse, let's go back, that's on the 3rd, this is MSN. NASA says that the apocalypse is not now. Do you see this shot right there? NASA, or this shit right here? NASA says that the apocalypse, and they have this drawing of Nibiru, right? We're not going to get into the details of it, but just to show the proof positive of when this article is, they're telling people that all this talk about the apocalypse and Nibiru, they don't see nothing. They say they're blind to this, that it's not now. You understand? It's not now. And then we open up the article right here, and they have it labeled that apocalypse not now, 2012 doomsday debunked. But they have bunkers, right? They have a whole bunch of hidden underground bunkers. That's true. They're putting out strange messages, you know, to their own people. But they're telling the rest of the people, they're saying that, well, this is all junk news and they don't have no proof of it. And they don't see anything. I think that's the curious thing, is that if you trust them, then you trust them. Then hopefully they got your back. But based on what we're all able to witness and see, we're living in strange times. Definitely living in very strange times. But they're saying that don't worry about it. The apocalypse is not now. As you can see, apocalypse not now. 2012 doomsday predictions are debunked by NASA. When I saw this, I said, is this a comedy? Is this a joke? I mean, knowing what we know about NASA and the so-called Nazi scientists, you understand, and what they've been doing and all their special black ops projects. But here's on the space news. Notice it's under space. It's under the space news on MSNBC, owned by General Electric. And just so you understand, you know, that little disclaimer. So this whole article has a lot of interesting points. We wanted to show you some of the pictures that they have. This picture right here is supposed to be a picture of Nibiru. This is supposed to be an artist's rendition, an artist's conception of the rogue planet Nibiru or Planet X. They want to say they don't have any information. They blacked out all the information concerning this. And then they tried to go through and debunk some of the individual points. You know, like there's no sign of Nibiru. They said so forth and so on. The Mayan calendar, they said a rogue planet. They tried to put a question mark because people probably asking them questions and saying, NASA, why you block out certain parts of the constellation? Why do you block out certain things in Venus constellation? Why do you block out certain things in the Leo constellation? They probably won't talk about that too much. But then they have some woman here who's in contact, Nancy Lever. She's the one who was in contact with some aliens from the Zeta Reticuli. You understand? And they first said that Nibiru will cause widespread disaster in May 2003. Only to change it to December 21st, 2012. Now, there is some realism too, as well, that's not getting too much airplay, that 2012 is like just opening a stargate, you know, opening a door, opening a portal. You know what I mean? It's like if you open something, doesn't mean that something's going to come through right then, but means that it has open access. But here's what they said. However, there's no evidence that Nibiru is real. But then what we can also say, there's no evidence that Nibiru is not real. But this particular scientist says Nibiru is ridiculous because it doesn't exist. You know, these guys are discovering stuff every day, but he's saying it doesn't exist. It never existed as anything other than a figment of the imagination by pseudoscientists. He's trying to say that he's trying to pat himself and his boys on the back, that they're real scientists. They work for NASA, who don't seem bothered by a complete lack of evidence. Of course, because they're suppressing a lot of evidence, said astronomer Don Yeomans, So they give him a kind of like a native kind of name, and you say, oh, he must be known the truth. Manager of NASA's Near Earth Object Program Office at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California, told Space.com. But wait, hold up a moment. Didn't NASA shut down? Oh, they just shut down its public stuff. Oh, I get it. They just gonna keep working government stuff. Oh. So government secrecy, military secrecy. Oh. I get it. But anyway, he said there's no basis for the claim that it might be lurking behind the sun, as it could not have hidden from observation until now, Yeoman said. But there's actual evidence that they've seen some strange phenomena that could only be a planet. That's why they call it a black planet, because they really can't get a clear sight of it. So it's a black planet. And such a planet was headed towards Earth by December 21st, 2012. It would already be visible to the naked eye. Notice what he says, to the what? Naked eye. He should be ashamed, like Adam and Eve were ashamed when they were deceived. To the naked eye. Remember Adam and Eve? They were ashamed when they got some sort of consciousness, so-called. But anyway, cosmic alignments. There's also concerns that planets or stars might line up in ways that will transform Earth. For instance, some theorists claim that from our point of view, the sun will cross in front of the plane of our galaxy on December 21st. However, the sun already does this twice a year, Yeoman said. How come he didn't tell you when? Oh, I guess all the news that's fit to print, huh? In fact, the sun will eventually cross the plane of our galaxy. However, the sun is about 67 light years from the galactic plane, so it should take several million years to do so. Yeoman said, even then, when our solar system finally does cross the plane, nothing special will occur, he added. How does he know? Now, they said these are 10 failed doomsday predictions, but then our black Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, already told us that there will be many false prophets that will come, even in his name. So we should also, you know, take that to head and heart. But some also claim that gravitational effects from planets lining up with each other will somehow affect Earth. However, there's no planetary alignment due on December 21st, 2012. And if there were, it wouldn't cause any problems. So he's telling us that there's none. I wish they should put a picture of this guy, but they didn't put no picture of this guy, so we know really who is. The only bodies that will have any significant gravitational impact on Earth are the moon and the sun, effects we see as tides. Remember water? Remember Hurricane Katrina? You remember the tsunami? NASA couldn't predict that. Tidal effects from other bodies in our solar system are negligible at best. And in any case, we have experienced them for millions of years without notice. You get that? Millions of years, yet the white supremacy system only been around for a couple of hundred years, really knowing that the Earth was not flat. Remember, these are the same people, European people, that thought the Earth was flat when the Egyptians and the ancient Ethiopians knew better. Then it talks about solar storms, debunking that, flip-flop Earth, debunking, trying to debunk the magnetic poles and so forth and so on. They say it's going to take a long time. This is the same thing they do with biblical prophecy as well. You know, they try to put it into the indefinite future. It might happen at some time in the future, so that if it does happen, you know, hopefully it'll take you out, but not them, and they'll just say, well, how come we didn't know? They have no responsibility, cosmic impacts. But there's something very important about articles like this, too, because it does point to something that's very important. People are looking at these dates like 2012, December 21st, 2012, as though the date is supposed to do something, and people have forgotten that the heavens of the heavens belong to Jah, belong to God, but the earth he has given to the sons of men. So really, the earth and earth-related things are really our purview. And if we want to see change, then, of course, you know what we got to do? We got to make change happen. See, the right time can come, But if the people are not aware of that and responding properly, then they basically lose the opportunity of time. Just some food for thought as we once again just look at this news article. Will they have to eat their words, people? Only time will tell. Shalom, Rastafari.